Hey guys, Dan here with CLE Tech, and another start of a new year means another CES. And this is going to be my third CES. For those of you who don't know, CES stands for Consumer Electronics Show. It's one of the biggest in the world, and I will have already jetted off to Las Vegas by the time you've seen this video. And another CES means it's time for another What's in My Camera / Tech Bag. So I wanted to show you all of the tech and camera gear that I'm going to be using to cover the showroom floor.
Before we get started, in order to ensure you don't miss my latest videos, be sure to turn on notifications for my channel. And if you're new to my channel, I hope you decide to hit that subscribe button too.
Starting off with the star of the show, we have this year's backpack of choice, and that is the Bolt Backpack from Waterfield Designs. Made from really premium materials like wax canvas or ballistic nylon, and full grain leather, there is no second guessing the amount of quality and craftsmanship that you get from these backpacks. The model that I have here is the ballistic nylon and grizzly leather, and I absolutely love the two-tone look with the black and brown colors. Obviously, what really makes this backpack a great pickup is the amount of storage and compartments that are available. So on the sides of the bag, you have two pockets perfect for water bottles or coffee mugs, and maybe your keys in the other. There's also a smaller front zippered compartment that is great for pens and notebooks, but there are also two hidden compartments with a magnetic closure that's perfect for a phone or wallet. The back of the bag has that perforated material to help with temperature regulation, and you can also stick your carry-on handle through the flap so that you can easily lug your bags around the airport. Finally, getting into the main compartment of this backpack, you will immediately notice that you have tons of room for all of your tech and personal belongings. The inside has that goldish patterned material that we've seen from other Waterfield design bags, and there are a couple of extra pockets and compartments for smaller items like your laptop chargers and cables, and then a sleeve for your iPad or any other tablet that might be around the 10-inch size, as well as an additional laptop sleeve capable of fitting a 15-inch laptop with no problems. Also, if you're in a pinch or if TSA is yelling at you to take your laptop out of your bag so that they can check it, there's an additional waterproof zippered compartment for quick and easy access to your laptop or tablets. So now that we've seen everything that this bag is capable of actually taking with me, I'm not going to be filling it up to the brim like years past because I just don't need all of that stuff on the showroom floor. Now, I don't mind packing extra bags to take with me and storing some of that other tech that I might need in the hotel room, but that's just things that I can just switch out later if I need something for a different day on the showroom floor. However, my goal is to be as nimble and quick as possible, only carrying with me the main essentials. So with that said, these are the absolute necessities that I need in order to cover CES 2018. So let's take a look at the main compartment first, and in the laptop sleeve, I'll obviously be bringing my 2016 15-inch MacBook Pro with Touch Bar. This is my main computer at the moment and is what I use to edit nearly every single video that I make for each channel. Usually when I travel, I like to take my iPad Pro with me so that I can maybe get some emails or scripts written on a plane, and of course, watch some Netflix too. This year, I plan to only bring my Sony a6500 with me on this trip, and my Sigma 18-35 lens alongside some Sony lenses like the 10-18 f4 and the 35mm f2.8. Now I'll probably be using those last two lenses quite a bit when walking around the showroom floor, just because of the great autofocus and image stabilization that the lens and a6500 offer. This could eliminate the need for a tripod, but I'll probably bring my Manfrotto B-Free tripod because it is super lightweight and portable. Now, of course, to power all of that stuff, we will need my various pouch of cables and chargers, batteries for the camera, and their corresponding chargers. I'll also be bringing a few phones with me, of course, and this year we have my current daily driver, the iPhone X, and I'll be coupling that with my Apple Watch Series 3. I absolutely love traveling with this combination, so it was kind of a no-brainer. I'll also always carry an Android phone with me, and I will be bringing the Google Pixel 2 XL this time, because of course it's a fantastic camera, and well, it's just an all-around great phone. A huge shout out to Verizon for sending one out for me to check out. Finally, for audio solutions, you know it's hard to travel without a great pair of noise-canceling headphones for the plane, and so I usually bring my Bose QC35s, but this year we got a new pair. These are the Sony MDX-1000 Mark IIs, and so far they are absolutely awesome. Now I will have a full video comparing these headphones to some others like the QC35s, but I definitely need to do some more testing, and this trip is the perfect opportunity. Of course, I'll also have my pride and joy, the AirPods, with me at all times, and I'll also give the Pixel Buds another chance because, well, if everything else is dead, I have something to use. Finally, in terms of audio for my videos, I'm actually going to be bringing a couple of different solutions. So one is the Rode NT USB microphone, which plugs right into my computer and I can do some really good voiceovers with when I'm not on camera. And then for when I am on camera, I haven't decided if I'm gonna go with the Rode Video Mic Pro Plus, just sticks on top of the camera there and it's just a shotgun mic that points at me, or the Rode Filmmaker set, which is a wireless lav that I'm currently wearing to make this video, and I've been using for all of the videos that I've been on camera with. Just haven't decided which one I'm gonna do, but they're all from Rode, and this isn't a sponsorship. I just love their products, and I've been using them exclusively for pretty much my entire YouTube career. So with that said, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss my CES coverage. And this has been a look at all of the tech and gear that I am bringing to cover CES 2018. So if you like this video, be sure to hit that like button. And of course, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.